God. Hallelujah. God bless everyone again that is able to join us in today's service. God's word is coming to you today, Sunday, which God has blessed for your life. I'm glad you could make it to join us. Can you quickly bring members of your family together? Call your husband, call your wife, call your children and your neighbors. Let them come together with you as we worship God, as we listen to the word that God has had for us for today in this service. God's word shall be good to you and your family, and you will never bow your head in shame. My name is Apostle Mike Honor Akinyuade from the Royalty Place, TRP, Lagos, Nigeria. God bless you. Hallelujah. Lord Jesus, we exalt you, we worship you, we glorify your holy name. And thank you for that man, that woman, that your word is coming expressly to for this service today. Whose life you want to change? Whose destiny you want to remove? Father, we love you. Mighty Jesus, we exalt you forever. Hallelujah. Amen and amen. In Jesus' name, I have prayed. Father, give power to your word. Bless us by the power of the word and by the word of your power. In Jesus' mighty name, I have prayed. The word of God that is coming to you and your family today is a continuation of what the Lord has started with us in the month of May. Has told me to declare the grace to arise again. Spoke on this the first Sunday, and the second Sunday we're speaking about the grace that will perfect all things in your life. Grace for perfection, for completion of the projects, the business, the things you have started, and that the Holy Ghost has started for you to bring them all into perfection. Today, I'm bringing a word for you from the scripture, and I'm reading from the book of 1 Peter and chapter 5. 1 Peter chapter 5. If you have your Bible there, can you open to 1 Peter chapter 5? And as I read just one verse, verse 10 of 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 10. And it says, "But may the God of all grace," I'm reading from the New King James Version. The King James says, "But the God of all grace," the New King James says, it puts it as a prayer, "But may the God of all grace, who called us to his eternal glory by Christ Jesus, after you have suffered a while," hey, can you hear that? Now let me put it this way: perfect, establish, strengthen, and settle you. That is a powerful word. Now listen to me, let me paraphrase it this way. He's saying, may the God of all grace, who has called us unto eternal glory through Christ Jesus, may he perfect you, may he establish you, may he strengthen you, and may he settle you. He said, after you have suffered a while, listen to me. There is a God in heaven that is called the God of all grace. Hear me. Grace is available with God. Grace is available in God. I'm looking at grace for particular assignment in your life, grace for special assignment in your family, for special encounter with you. Hallelujah. He said, may that God that has all grace, what grace are you looking for? Follow me in this message, somebody. What grace are you looking for? What grace have you been praying for? Listen, that people take grace to the extreme for what kind, for whatsoever kind of misbehavior, does not mean grace is no more available. That people take grace to an extreme, hear it again, that people take grace to an extreme and they took it to make them misbehave in whatever kind of character and behavior does not mean the true grace of God doesn't or is not available. Grace is available in God, though not a license for sin. Grace is available in God, with God, and it is not a license for sin. I'm preaching today on the grace of God that will settle matters. The grace of God to settle matters. Listen to me. That scripture says, may the grace, he said, may the God of all grace, speaking about God himself, the creator of the ends of the universe, who has grace with him, who has grace in him, he says, the God of all grace, I'm praying for somebody, that this God of all grace will be your God. And I quickly invite you into this God through Jesus Christ. That scripture is clear. He said, may the God of all grace, listen to the next line. He said, who hath called us? So there is a God of all grace. What did he do? He called us. Listen to me. There is a call coming to you, wherever you may be now, to come unto this God. He is stretching forth his hand to bring you close to himself. The God of grace, listen to me. The God of grace is calling you to himself. Oh my God. The God of grace, God in his infinite mercy, God in his power of grace is calling you. I want you to do the bidding of the Lord. I want you to yield unto this calling. He said, the God of all grace, who had called us. What did he call us into? That's the next thing. He called us into eternal glory. Oh my God. The call of God, the God of grace to you, is that he is bringing you into eternity. Oh, listen to me. This eternity has glory in it. Listen, you need to hear this. There are two types of eternity. People will live eternally in two dimensions. Oh, let me say it this way. They will live in hell, which is burning, and the scripture says, there they will be forever and ever and ever. That is one eternity. But there is eternity with glory. You didn't hear that. Eternal glory. A glory that nothing can short. A kind of glory that nothing can block. He said, the God of all grace, which I'm preaching about here, called you. He didn't call you into destruction. He didn't call you into affliction. He didn't call you into destruction, not into affliction. He called you into glorious life. He said, this God that has called us into eternal glory, through whom? He said, he called you through Jesus Christ. Oh, celebrate Jesus wherever you may be. Oh, can you give the Lord Jesus a praise wherever you may be? Jesus is glorified forever and ever and ever. God the Father, whom we are speaking about here, the God of all grace, the God of all grace, who called us, called you, called me, he called us into eternal glory. He said, through Jesus Christ. He's not speaking to you. He said, after you have suffered a while. Listen to me, somebody. Whatever you have been going through in the past years of your life are called the suffering for a while. Even the pandemic situation all over the world is what is called the suffering for a while. You've been passing through issues, through certain things, through matters, through difficult times. That is what is called suffering for a while. You've been married for years and trusting God for children, and they have not come. That is what is called suffering for a while. You have started a business, and the business has been up and down, nosediving even now. It rose to a certain height, then it plateaued. After plateauing, it began to nosedive, coming down. That is what is called suffering for a while. I have a word for you. In this time of grace, he said, may the God of all grace who called us, there's a call for you. What is this call saying? He's calling you out of this suffering for a while. Heaven is at work for your life, for your family, and bringing you out of this suffering for a while. This is what grace is doing now. The grace that is perfecting things for you, that is settling things for you. Oh, what a grace that heaven is bringing your way today. 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 10. That is the scripture. Hallelujah. But may the God of all grace. Oh, I see grace sufficient for your life. The God of all grace, who hath called us unto eternal glory through Jesus Christ. Oh, you need to have this Jesus in your life, because that is the way through whom you were called. Oh, that call had been there, that you should come out of your old ways, depart from your old lifestyle, depart from the things that do not glorify God, come out of it all. That is the call. He said, may this God who called you by his eternal, into his eternal glory through Christ Jesus, he's not speaking to you. He said, after all your sufferings for a while, which is called light afflictions. Oh, the whole world had been under the lockdown of coronavirus, in nations all over the world. Nations are getting out of this lockdown little by little, and our nation, Nigeria too, will soon be out of it very soon. Listen to me. Everything that happened during the lockdown, during the pandemic, is what I call your suffering for a while. Are you listening to me, somebody? Oh, your business went down during the pandemic. That is what I call suffering for a while. Oh, 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 10. God's word coming expressly to you, this man, watch me right now. To you, this woman, listen to me right now. To you, that family, passing through situations and circumstances, and watch me right now. God's word coming to your family right now, that there's a God in heaven. He is called the God of all grace. What did he do? I said, he called you. He called you into his eternal glory. Through whom? I said, through Jesus Christ, you were called into his eternal glory. And this call that you were called, he said, you were called into that eternal glory. And I said, after you have suffered a while. Now listen to me. What is your suffering for a while? Put it there. Put it there. You've been waiting upon the Lord for things. You've been in situations and circumstances for many things that have been happening over your life in whatever ways. You've been all around it, which is called the suffering for a while. Listen to me. What this word of God is saying. You are a student, and you have had issues with your studies. You have tried all sorts of things, read in the morning, midnight, afternoon, you are not getting it. It is God that's suffering for you, right? And the wisdom of God will be coming upon you right now. Just watch me, just listen to me. Your business, your ministry, your family, your marriage have been passing through storms. Storms here and there. You have been beaten to the right and to the left. It is what I call suffering for a while. I have a good news for you. And what is the good news? 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 10, same scripture. It says, after you have suffered for a while, may that God, may he perfect you. Listen to me. Last Sunday, the message I brought to us last Sunday said, grace for perfection. Look at it. It's a build-up. It's a backup and a continuation of it. Now that scripture says, after your suffering for a while, and the things you have gone through. Oh, the Lord is speaking to me now about somebody who is sick. And this sickness had been coming and going. It is even before coronavirus started. This is not about coronavirus. You've been having issues with your health over years. As a matter of fact, it has certain time of the year, particular month of the year, that it always comes back. I have a good news for you. Your health shall be perfected now. That is what the word of God is brought to you. After you have suffered for a while, he said, may the God of grace perfect you. What am I saying now? There is the grace of God for perfection. Perfection of the things that are not yet made whole. The things that you have started that have come to an average level or to the mid level, there is the grace of God. May the God of all kinds of grace that is needed. May the God of all grace perfect you. Oh, receive perfection. You need perfection. Receive perfection. Oh, be perfected in your health. Be perfected in your mind. I speak to your mind, to your brain. Be perfected in great wisdom. Oh, be perfected in that business. Be perfected in your calling and in your ministry. As a servant of God, the church of God in your hand, the ministry that the Lord has put in your hand, be perfected in it. Oh, halabo soteria. What has the Lord started for you? It will be perfected this week. It will be perfected this week for you. Because there is grace for perfection. The God of all grace. The God of all grace. He said, may he perfect you. Oh, thank you, Jesus Christ. Thank you, Jesus Christ. He said, may he establish you. Somebody listen to me. You need grace for establishment. Four things I'm speaking about. The first one is that grace perfects. The second thing I'm speaking is that the grace of God will establish you. Can you say, I am established? Say, I am established. Oh, business establishment, marriage establishment, family establishment, career establishment, ministerial establishment. Hear this. God is establishing higher platforms for somebody. Oh, platforms, doors of establishment, open it for you. If you are that person, say, I am the one. Doors of establishment in great places, Alatuza Pashataria, that heaven is bringing your way. The devil is in trouble. Oh, Satan is in trouble. He cannot do anything against this word that the Holy Ghost is bringing your way. There is the grace of God establishing you, establishing your life, your family, your business, your career, everything that you are going through. God is bringing establishment of perfection of things for you. Amen. Hallelujah. Oh, celebrate Jesus. Everyone celebrate the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, the I am that I am, the one that was, that is, and he shall come. May he establish you. The third thing, he said, may he strengthen you. Somebody listen to me. Listen to me. Do you know, in that verse 10 of that scripture, 1 Peter 5, verse 10, he said, after you have suffered a while, you know, the things we go through as challenges are like suffering. And can I say this to you? It is the grace of God that helps a man to pull through challenges. It is the grace of God that helps anybody to pull through and go through and not die in the suffering. I pray for you. You won't die in your suffering. I'm speaking to you. You won't die in your challenges. Oh, the grace of God will make you pull through. He said, after you have suffered a while, perfection will come. After you have suffered a while, there will be establishments. After you have suffered a while, there will be strengthening. You need an inner strength. Oh, strength from the inside, strength from the outside. Physical strength, spiritual strength. You need strength in prayers. You need strength in the word of God. Oh, you that your spirit is weary, that you cannot study the word of God again, you cannot pray again. You need spiritual strength. Get back into prayer. Get back into living right. Get back into studying the word of God. This is your strength. That is the food you need. You are feeding your body. You have not been feeding your spirit. Then you say you don't have faith. You cannot have faith if you don't feed your spirit. Get back to gain spiritual strength. You need the word of God. You need prayer. And there is grace for it. I pray for you. Receive grace that will strengthen you from the inside. Grace that will strengthen you from the outside. Inner strength, outward strength. Strength over everything. Oh, strength, be strengthened in the name of Jesus Christ. Strength is power. Strength is ability. Strength is capacity. May God give you. May He give you strength. May He give you capacity. There are things you want to do, but you can't do. It's because you don't have strength for it. No capacity. Oh, I pray, may the grace of God come upon you and give you capacity. May you receive capacities for the things you want to do, for the missions, the visions, the assignment, the purpose of God in your life. Receive capacity. Strength is capacity. Oh God. Oh, I receive capacity. Are you saying that? Is that your word? See, I receive strength. I receive capacity. What's the fourth thing that this grace will do? The first thing I said, it will give, it will perfect you. It will establish you. It will strengthen you. And the fourth thing that it will do, he said, it will settle you. You need settlement. Oh my God. You have been single. You've been alone. Your settlement is here now. Marriage settlement is coming for you. The Lord wants to settle a home for you. He wants to settle matters for you. I hear in my spirit solutions to situations. Solutions to situations. Solutions to solutions to situations. Solutions to situations. This is what the Lord is bringing to you. How? By His grace that He bestows upon you. May the God of all grace, who has called us into His eternal glory, after we have suffered a while, may He perfect us. May He strengthen us, establish you, and settle is settle things for you. Oh God, that settlement you need, that is manana tariba hosiaka, a matter before you that is above you. You didn't hear what I said now. A matter before you that is above you. Who is the Lord speaking about now? You have a matter before you that is above you, but it is not up to God. That situation that is before you and above you is not up to God. It's only above you in your humanity. It's not above you in your spirit realm. If you build your spirit, gain spiritual strength, I declare the situation before you that is above you in your humanity, may it be settled by the grace of God. May it be settled by the grace of God. 1 Peter chapter 5 and verse 10. May the God of all grace settle matters for you. Oh, there's this grace of God available in the house here now. Available right now as I pray for you. Leto sutaria. I want you to be in the mood of prayer right now. If you have not given your life to Jesus Christ, begin to confess your sins. And you ask for forgiveness. Say, Lord, have mercy on me. Because grace is not a license for sin. Grace is not a license for sin.
The grace of God is to perfect you. Can you imagine? It's to perfect your life. In another word, that perfection is to bring you out of sin into perfection. Bringing you out of a sinful state, sinful life, and bring you into a life in Christ Jesus. Begin to pray and say, Lord, I receive grace to perfect my life. To perfect my life and bring me out of my old state into a newness of life. Oh, la bobo suteteria. Oh, the God of all this, he wants to hear your voice. He wants to hear your voice. He wants to hear you cry unto him. Can you cry unto this God of grace? And you say, oh God of grace, have mercy on me. Manataya bosia. Iko sutaria. Grace and mercy and favor, they work together. Can you cry unto Jehovah God? Oh God of all grace, have mercy on me. Oh, thank you, Jesus Christ. Oh, in Jesus' name we have prayed. You have not given your life to Jesus Christ, and you have prayed a prayer of dedication, asking him to forgive you all your sins and to bring you into new life with him. I congratulate you that forgiveness is with the God of grace. That is what grace does. He forgives. He forgives. And you say, son, don't go there anymore. Don't go back into your sin. Daughter, don't go back into your old state. Now, get a new life. And that is what has happened to you now. May the Lord forgive you. And as you have received forgiveness, do not go back there. The Spirit of the Lord comes upon your life in a new way. In the name of Jesus Christ. These four things that I've spoken about that grace can do to settle, to make this happen for you, will happen in your life. Perfection is coming. Mark this word today in this Sunday service, this Sunday broadcast that you're listening to. Mark this word today that in the third Sunday in the month of May, that the word of God had come to you, which is as an extension and a continuation of the word from the first Sunday of the month about grace of God to make you arise and to perfect things for you. And I said to you that it certainly matters for you. Perfection of your life, establishing you, strengthening you, and settling things. Can you say it is settled? Jesus said it is finished. Take the last time. And it has the word for you, for your family, that it is finished. Everything is finished. He has done it. The debt is paid. It is settled. Can I hear you say that? It is settled. Can you say, I am settled? The Lord settled me. He settled that business matter, family matter, marriage matter, career matter, everything. Settled. Give God all the glory. Give God all the praise. Can you go ahead and worship him? And give him all the glory. The name Jesus. Hallelujah. What a beautiful name it is. What a glorious name that name is. Oh, the God of all grace who had called us into his eternal glory through Christ Jesus. And after you have suffered a while, you have gone through things. Oh, I know you've been patient. You have endured. Your settlement is coming. You have endured. Your settlement is coming. Your patience is paying up now. Oh, that is your word now. That patience you've had, you have waited on God. And because you have waited on God, you cannot be put to shame. Perfection, establishment, strength, capacity, and settlement coming for you. Glorify Jesus. Hallelujah. Listen to me. If you are led to support us, reach out to us. Let's know that the Lord has touched your heart to support the work of God in our hands. This is the Royalty Place TRP, Lagos, Nigeria. Mike Honor Akinyade and Apostle is my name, and I'm saying, God bless you. Grace will work for you. Go in this week and have everything done in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. God bless your family. Amen.